You are alive? Am I alive? Am I alive? So I'm not sure if it's already live or not. Waiting for Morgonaut. I still wait for Morgonaut. Still waiting for Morgonaut. Can you somebody please write me if you can see me and if you can hear me? I have no idea. So let's pretend it's working. So let's welcome everybody by my overall first live stream ever. And because I'm super crazy, that's also my first live stream, which is running completely in 4K on several cameras. So if anything will go wrong, so please excuse me. That's my first experience with live streaming. So I have here also quite a bit of comments. So let's jump straight into it. But it's running too fast. It's too fast. How can I deal with modern card like GTX 1060 and Hackintosh? Thank you. You know, what would you do? What would you like to do with it? You know, GTX 1060 is quite super old card. It's not a bad card. I am still using it in my virtualization server over there. But, you know, don't expect any miracles out of it. And don't forget you need High Sierra, because it will not run in macOS Mojave and it will not run in macOS Catalina. So for a lot of people, High Sierra is still perfect system. I personally would not touch it anymore, because why? When I have... Sorry. Elvir Begovic, did you hear that Apple is working on AMD CPU support? AMD Ryzen powered Macs spotted in macOS 10.15.4. Yes, I registered several posts like that. First feeling was, if that's true, then I would be sad, because I am super old school, conservative, and, you know, Threadrippers in Mac Pro, that would be great, but not quite shortly after I invested so much money into this. So that would piss me off. Maybe, you know, I think if you saw that article, it's mentioning only the APUs. There is no sign of any Threadripper or Ryzens without the integrated GPU. So, you know, maybe for some MacBook, okay. That I could survive, but not for my Mac Pro. Again, Elvir Begovic, Linus needs your help. He is building a Hackintosh. Apple beat us, but we are still trying. Yes, I saw that video series and his tries. You know, this is 14-core iMac Pro killer. Inside, it's the Designare build. And he's trying to put inside 28-core monster. You know, why? It will still not have so many PCI Express slots as the Mac Pro. So trying to recreate a Mac Pro yourself is quite impossible task. He is trying it, you know, he's not successful yet, but, you know, let him wish luck. Daniel Bogutsky. Do you guys know I have Catalina fully working, but when I open new apps or change category in settings, my Catalina becomes slower and mouse pointer is jumping instead of smooth move. Are you sure you have correct USB port mappings done? Okay. Dusan Paklar. Hey, Oscar winning Morgonaut. Among all of those builds you done, what parts are confirmed as constant in your builds and why? Greetings from Serbia. I'm not sure what you mean by constant, but you know, overall, the 14-core iMac Pro killer behind me, watch my video series about it, is far the best price to performance ratio which you can buy. Because, you know, I have a lot of people asking me, why don't you do any X299 build? And the answer is absolutely clear. You know, why should I do that when you will not gain so much performance for your money as you will get with this one? Of course, 8-core i9-9900K is not any super beast. But what does it also mean? That you will pay less than $500 for it, you know. 10980XE, $1,000. Motherboards are much much more expensive, and the performance gain over the 9900K is simply not as good as I could justify the price difference. And of course, I have to build builds for majority of people, not for super minority. And of course, should I invest now money into X299 build just because you want a video about it? Don't think so. Ah, hello Nanotech. Hello, do you have a good mainboard for my first Hackintosh build? i7-8700K, RX580, 16GB Corsair Vengeance program, water cooling. You know, for 16GB build, I think it's quite does not matter what motherboard you will put in. But overall, don't forget that motherboard is the most important part of any Hackintosh. I see a lot of people are, you know, they will watch my 14-core iMac Pro killer video, and what they will do, the Designare is, I don't know, now $200. I have no exact no idea. Let's pretend it's $200. And they think, okay, so, but I see this one, blah, 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 Gigabyte, blah, blah, and it's $20 cheaper, so I will buy it. And then they will start to complain it's not working. You know, don't try to save money on motherboard. I would recommend if you don't have the budget for a super amazing build, simply instead of i9 or i7, you know, save money and buy i5. You can upgrade it later. But to upgrade the motherboard in Hackintosh means that you would need completely new build from scratch EFI configuration. And do you really want to undercome all the pain once again? You know, simply grab my 14-core iMac Pro Killer, that's the Z390 Designare motherboard, save money on other parts, but you can this later anytime upgrade to much better computer. Cheers. Will Cook is asking, can you use 128 gigs of RAM with the Gigabyte Z390 Designare? And what's the best currently supported graphics card for metal acceleration? Gigabyte Z390 Designare claims that it supports 128 gigs of memory. But when you will look into the motherboard's QVL qualified vendors list, there is a quite no, not quite, but you know, 1 month ago there was absolutely no 32 gig sticks there. So what I would do if I would like to put 128 gigs into my Designare motherboard, I would simply contact Gigabyte directly. Write them email or on their forum, hey, your QVL is missing 32 gig sticks. Write me what sticks are compatible. And especially, you know, a lot of people underestimate the information in the QVL, and I see it super often. You know, what people do, they don't care about what memory choose for that particular motherboard. So it's very often people tell me, hey, I even cannot start the computer now when I enable the XMP profile. You know, sure, Z platform, so Z390 in this case, is quite very sensitive and have high demands on the memory controller overall. So if you will put there four sticks, and it does not need to be 128 gigs of memory, you know, it can be perfectly only 64 gigs. But if you will put there some memory which is fast with low timings, and that memory is not on the motherboard's QVL, you know, I bet at 99% of chance you will have big problems. So yes, you can probably use that memory, but you will have to spend insane amount of time on tweaking it. That means to find the highest possible stable frequency on the low as low timings as possible. And if you ever ran Memtest 86 on 64 gigs of memory, you would know it take, I think, 9 hours, one round. So you are waiting like a crazy just to run single test, and you will see error. Okay, so let's go back to BIOS, retweak it. You know, that's not what I would like, how I would like to spend my time. So second part, so contact the Gigabyte directly. So if they tell you that the exact code of memory they recommend and you will buy it, then it then if that will not work, simply you know where to complain. Second part of the question, where was the question? Oh god, I lost it. Yeah, and what's the best currently supported graphics card for metal acceleration? You know, metal acceleration have even my super old RX 480, you know, or 560. They have all the same metal acceleration. What probably you mean is what's the most powerful supported GPU for macOS with metal acceleration, and that's of course the Radeon 7. Radeon 7 is in fact the same GPU as is in the new 2019 Mac Pro. It has, you know, the Apple card has, I think, 4096 shaders, and Radeon 7 has only 3800 something, so it's about 5% less cores, and it has only 16 gigs of memory against the 32 gigs of VRAM, which has the Apple card. But if you will look at Barefeeds, for example, you know, by the way, I love that site, barefeeds.com, I think. That's a site which is doing benchmarks and tests of all Macs, you know, maybe for last 20 years. So that was a quite good resource when I was young. And there you can see that in real life, there is absolutely no difference between Radeon 7 and the Vega Pro 2 GPU in the Mac Pro. So if you ask what's the currently best, you know, what's the best? You know, best for me is the Radeon 7, and for someone else, it's the RX 560. So it depends on what you mean. Best and most powerful GPU is the Radeon 7. Okay, so what's the next? Are we able to enable HDR support on 10.15 Hackintosh? You know, I never tried HDR because I have on top of here, maybe you can see it now, it's not running. It's my 10-bit grading panel, but it's connected directly to my Blackmagic Decklink card, so I don't have any option how to connect it. Especially not to my RX 580 now, and I don't want to connect anything to my Radeon 7 GPUs inside of this Mac Pro. So honestly, I have no idea. I think it should work out of the box. If not, I cannot help you. Oh, it's scrolled up. I lost the chat now. Hi, Andrew Hart. Hi, Teresa. Can you tell me what card provides the Wi-Fi Bluetooth 5 on the Mac Pro? What card provides Wi-Fi Bluetooth 5? You know, I can look at what's inside of this Mac Pro, but probably I will have no idea. It's some Broadcom cores and Wi-Fi not listed, you know. Probably I don't understand well your question. Maybe you ask if you can grab this insides of the Mac Pro and use it in your Hackintosh. No, of course not, because it does not have any dedicated Wi-Fi Bluetooth card. But I made a video about Wi-Fi, about the card, which now I have absolutely no idea where it is. No idea where it is. Simply watch my video, which is called, I forgot it, simply, you know, search for Wi-Fi on my YouTube channel. That's the card I recommend, but, you know, I don't use it. You know, first, what I've done on this Mac Pro was to disable Wi-Fi. I'm using only Bluetooth for the original Apple Bluetooth keyboard. First haters. Let's say we are not welcomed. Hello and greetings from Germany. It's the 32-bit application problem fixed with AMD. Darling, I have no idea. I don't use AMD. I use AMD only as a virtualization platform. Can I use Gigabyte RX 470 4G for Mojave? Asks Milan Dimitrov. You know, overall RX 470 should have no problem. But I would have the problem with the Gigabyte because, you know, overall what I always recommend, any GPU of the first choice would be Sapphire one. If you remember when Apple first came with eGPU support, I don't know, a few years ago, they tested and recommended officially the Sapphire, I think it was RX 580. And simply Sapphire cards are the most compatible. A lot of people also ask me, hey, since your video about Radeon 7, all Sapphire Radeon 7s are completely sold out everywhere, can I use, I don't know, XFX, blah, 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 other brands? And my answer is always the same. I strictly recommend only components I personally tested and verified. I don't trust anybody on forums, I don't read any forums, you read forums, but I would not trust all the information there. So if you still look at the forums, you will see a lot of people reported problems with the non-Sapphire version. A lot of other people has no problems with other brands. So it's simply a lottery. If you will buy it, try it, if it's not gonna work, you can return it in, I don't know, 14-15 days after the purchase. So RX 470 should work in Mojave, but I would not choose the Gigabyte one, sorry. Andrew Hart, no 32-bit apps on Catalina. Yes, that's true, no 32-bit apps on Catalina. So that's why I never recommended Catalina to anybody. I have to run Catalina on this Mac Pro because it cannot run on anything lower than Catalina, but overall, you know, I had huge problems, you know, when I started the Mac Pro for the first time, you know, excitement, okay, I got, after a lot of years, new Mac Pro, you know. First, what I wanted to do was to log in into iCloud, you know, perfect on the first run, but what happened? You know, no synchronizing of Safari, iMessage was not working, you know, these problems I would, no, not, I would not expect on Hackintosh, but a lot of people expect that on Hackintosh. But in fact, I never had such a problems on any of my Hackintosh builds as I had with my new amazing 2019 Mac Pro. And I was able to fix that after 2 days. So my first 2 days with new Mac Pro was not full of excitement, but I was really pissed off. So what was the question? Sorry. Yeah, no 32-bit apps. Yeah, so that's also another reason why I still always recommend Mojave. Start thinking about Catalina not earlier than in September when new macOS version will be released. So hopefully all problems on Catalina will be already fixed. But, you know, a lot of people, what they do, they need the newest everything, you know, newest bootloader, newest kernel extensions, newest operating system, newest everything. You know, it's a stupid idea. You know, when you will look at any production house, and I don't want to call again super big Pixar or any big production studio, you know, they are running for 4, 5, 6 versions behind operating systems and also not always the latest versions of applications. Why? Because they are crazy? No, because they are not crazy. Because they simply need a stable and predictable environment. So, as a lot of people know already on the Catalina, when it was 10.15.0, then 1, 2, and so on, you know, there was a lot of changes inside and it helped with support of something and broke support for something else. You know, do you really want next time when you will upgrade, then reinstall whole computer just because you were curious how the new version will bring something super amazing? You know, don't expect anything super amazing, you know. It's gonna run like this, maybe a little better for me, at least on the Mac Pro. It's scrolling too fast. Sorry, that is too much comments. Troy passed. Do I need VTD turn on in BIOS for VMware or Parallels? You know, VMware are companies who are selling products, and VMware Fusion, for example, is a software-based virtualization software, but VMware ESXi is hardware-based hypervisor. So I don't use any software virtualization, because why should I have crippled and low performance from my hardware when I can simply start the press button, press the start button on my virtualization server, and I have full hardware acceleration. If you have no idea what I'm talking about, please watch my video, which is called "What's Better Than Hackintosh Mac or Linux Workstation" or something like this. Then I covered, you know, the basics of the virtualization, how it works, and why it is so amazing. So for the hardware virtualization, of course, you need the VTD, because VTD enabled in BIOS, because that's what gives you the option to pass through something to your virtual machine. So if I will have a GPU, which I want then to take full advantage of the acceleration and simply have the direct access to this GPU, I would pass through that GPU to the virtual machine, and that it would not be possible with VTD disabled. So for this use case, VTD enabled. By the way, if you plan, for example, on the same machine, run the virtualization hypervisor to test the capabilities, and besides to it, some Hackintosh system, then you can still have VTD turned on and just disable it in your config.plist. Mr. Raju, love you, Teresa. Thank you, that's nice. Could you please suggest a graphics card? I have Core i9-9300K with 32 gigs, but I have a little budget for graphics card. I'm looking RX 580 or 5500 XT. What do you think? It's better to ask me, what do you drink? You know, if you are looking for RX 580 or 5500 XT, then I'm not sure what you want to do with this computer, because those two cards are marginally, you know, very far away of each other with the performance. You know, Sapphire RX 580 Nitro Plus Pulse will work perfectly, but I have personally, yeah, it's a 5500, you know, sorry, I thought it's a 5700 XT, my bad, sorry. 5500 and 5700 XT, I have problem with it, and it's related to what I said about the Mac Pro. Problem is then it needs 10.15.1 and up version, so you be able to run it. And because Catalina is, by my opinion, not yet ready, then I would never recommend any Navy-based GPU. So, you know, if you want to have calm sleep and you can enjoy quite low performance of the RX 580, it would be perfectly fine. But it all depends on what you want to do with it. As I said, I have RX 580 in my Mac Pro. I have no problem with it, because I'm using it only to drive my displays, nothing else. So I don't expect any computational performance out of it. Messages retracted. What does it mean? I have no idea. Andrew Hart. Yes, can you do a video on performance differences, if any? Clever versus OpenCore. You know, I think there should be no difference between those two. And can you do a video? Darling, I would like to do so many videos. I have so many plans and so many videos in several stages, but time is my enemy. So I don't say no, I don't say yes. Martin Shinkle probably. Running your 14-core iMac Pro killer build which works like a charm. Can you explain why some Thunderbolt devices are hot swappable and others not? You know, think about it. No, my answer is no. I cannot explain that because I am not using any Thunderbolt devices on my 14-core iMac Pro. My 14-core iMac Pro, in fact, is my recording computer and I don't use any Thunderbolt devices. You know, if simply is your Thunderbolt hot swap not working, think about it a little bit different. You saved $5,000 on this build, so I could survive that. Simply I have to plug my devices before the computer start, or don't shut down your computer. Sorry, I have no idea. Sorry, I want to install Mojave, can you tell me configurations? You know, watch my videos. There is a lot of hardware setups which will run Mojave perfectly. It's scrolling too fast. Sorry, I cannot reach it. Yeah, tady. So the Netropy all Radeon 7s are the same. Yeah, that's the best misunderstanding which is constantly on forums. No, they are not the same. How would you other explain that some Radeon 7s have problems and some does not have any problems? They look the same, everybody claims they are the same, but there is slight difference. Nobody can tell you in which. The vacuums were too small for vendors to make any customized version. As I said, some have problems, some not. So where's the same? It's not the same. Silvio Scardino. Hi Teresa, an alternative motherboard from Z390 with Thunderbolt support for Hackintosh. You know, I think there is a one more motherboard Z390 from Gigabyte with Thunderbolt support, but it's even more expensive than the Designare motherboard. So again, my choice number one, Z390 Designare. I have no idea why are you unsatisfied with Z390 Designare and you need different one. Hi Lisa. So Heil Sahaik is asking. I'm not Lisa, but it's okay. Maybe will Homer come for Lisa. I have iMac and MacBook Pro. Both are not showing 5 GHz Wi-Fi signals. Sometimes shows and disappears. Please, how I can fix it? You know, 5 GHz Wi-Fi signal is not so powerful as the 2.4 GHz signal, but advantage is that in each house with neighbors around, you will have 50 Wi-Fis on the 2.4 GHz spectrum and only few on 5 GHz. I experience 5 GHz problems with my iPhones, and I think I don't have problems now with the iPhone 11, but I had problems with it on my iPhone 6 Plus. And it was very sensitive to choose the correct, not to choose the correct band, but on your router to choose the correct frequency on which you will transmit the signal. I found some crazy combination. I cannot tell you now exact which one it was. Simply experiment with your frequencies on your router and then magically to some of these frequencies your iPhone will start to respond better. Q and Marco. Hi Teresa, what are your thoughts on Big Navy? You know, everybody is talking about it. Nobody had chance to see it. You know, different way. If I should buy now any GPU for my new Mac Pro, it would absolutely not be the Vega 2 GPUs from Apple, despite I like the dual GPU itself, but not for that insane money. For people like me who are delivering and everything doing in Apple Progress Codec, Navy GPU, even Big Navy or the biggest Navy on planet, would not help me too much. Navy will help to people which needs to connect a lot of displays because it supports the stream compression, which Radeon 7s and Vega 2 Apple GPUs does not support. And also it will be benefit for people who are delivering, so exporting their videos into H.264 or 5. And that would be perfect also for smaller Navi like 5700 XT. But big Navi, you know, let's be nicely surprised. If it's gonna be two times powerful as the 5700 XT, then you can look at the performance of Radeon 7 with a new card on newer process, newer technology, which will just eat a little bit less memory, but probably gonna cost much more than Radeon 7. Pavel Jakalak, Gigabit Designare Z390 has two Thunderbolt 3 ports. Yes, you are correct. Netropy, for other AMD cards I would recommend Sapphire and PowerColor because other vendors reuse Nvidia heatsinks. I cannot say if other vendors reuse Nvidia heatsinks. Simply Sapphire is always number one choice for me. References to AMD CPUs found in macOS. No, references to AMD APUs was found in macOS, Mr. Oscar Bravo. Oh god, it's scrolling again. Wait a second, it's so fast. Why it's so fast? Green Gooseman, do you have any opinion on Unraid? Yes, I have. And a lot of people will not like it, as always. Sorry, you know, Unraid. First, I don't have problem to pay for products which are good, you know. By the way, that's also, I don't know where it is, I cannot find it now. I wanted to show you a few licenses which I bought, but not for Unraid. You know, why to use Unraid when you can have something much better and open source, free? It's on my side, not about the price. I was testing it, I think, 1.5 years ago, and I would not have no problem to pay for it if it would be great. But for me, it's not great. So if you are looking for, I don't know, for what use case you want to use Unraid, if for pure virtualization or if you want to have it as a file server, you know, for virtualization and also for the file server features, I would not use Unraid. Lucas Rivest, I am a digital designer and a MacBook Pro Hackintosh would be very beneficial to have for work on the road. MacBook Pro Hackintosh. Okay, so you probably mean to have some Hackintosh which is built from some PC laptop. And again, I have problem with this. And it's easy, you know, where is my MacBook? Yeah, it's behind me over there. You know, what makes the MacBook so amazing? That's not the CPU, that's even not the amazing display. For me, it's the trackpad. Because macOS is super efficient system for anybody who has no problem to learn shortcuts and the magic trackpad, you know, with all those amazing gestures. Simply, I would never try to build a Hackintosh on top of some PC laptop because that would never have the magic trackpad features, you know, even the size. So, you know, do it. If you don't care about magic trackpad, or how is it called in the MacBook, simply the Apple trackpad, go for it, but I would not do it. Prudhwe Rai Batini, Teresa, hello from India. Can you do a video of Hackintosh PC with Gigabyte motherboard, please? Mr. Prudhwe Rai Batini, you probably didn't see single of my videos because just with one exception, I built all builds on Gigabyte motherboard, so watch my videos. That's also, by the way, the biggest problem of people who are commenting under my videos. They are able to comment under video about Wi-Fi, what is the good solution for Wi-Fi, and I'm quite sick of these people. not of these people, these comments, because, you know, if you do a video about Wi-Fi, so you expect the people will watch that video about Wi-Fi and not click on that video and go immediately into comments, start asking what's good for Wi-Fi. You know, watch that video. Aitor is asking again the same question, which was, and the same question next, and the same question next, which was already really a lot of times in my comments under my videos. What's your thoughts on the Dune Pro case? Greetings. The same Rishad Mustafa opinion about the Dune Pro case. And again, a lot of people will not like my answer. And I know exactly which people. I don't like stealers. I talk about this in quite heavy discussion with some lawyer, and he tried to explain to me that they didn't steal anything. You know, I don't understand that. So you see Dune Pro case, which is 100% a ripoff of the Mac Pro case, and some lawyer told me it's not a steal. You know, in which world are we living? I don't get it. Simply, it's a normal case, and even not so good, but it just looks from the outside as the Mac Pro. Imagine you would build something amazing, you know, I don't know, hand-built car, and some company would immediately, if they will see it's amazing, start selling that design. What would you say at that moment? Probably you would not be so happy that somebody has stolen your design. That's my opinion. Robbie Rep, your guides have been great, but when I inject UHD 630, I lose display. Guides to fix this are complex for me. Any tips? Sapphire RX 580 on order. Darling, wait for your RX 580. Enable integrated GPU in your BIOS, but don't have it as a primary display adapter. Primary display adapter set to your RX 580. And I think even without any injections, only with little and whatever green, it should work for you perfectly fine. Darius Cotton. Hello, Teresa SP. I am interested Linux and needed to move up in my job, sysadmin. I have Ubuntu as VM now. What sites or books do you recommend to learn, and what certs do you recommend? You know, sysadmin. It's hard to know what do you mean by that. Simply, Ubuntu would never be my Linux distribution of my choice. I was for long years a super fan of CentOS. While most Linux distributions were already on kernel version 4 and higher, you know, they were on some, I don't want to say 2 something, but, you know, it's a, who is using CentOS? CentOS you can find, again, in big video production houses, you know, animation studios, simply where you need stability and, again, predictable environment. So I think the CentOS version 7 was on the market for maybe 6-7 years, you know, quite the same version. But what's interesting, I think somewhere in the fall, they released CentOS 8, you know, let's celebrate after 7 years new version, and also CentOS 8 Stream, which is the rolling release of the CentOS. So also, if you want some newer versions of applications and kernel, now you have the option. But really surprised me was the performance of the CentOS versus CentOS Stream and CentOS 8 versus other distributions. You know, it was super marginal. So if you would need really powerful system, you should not use Ubuntu. You know, Ubuntu is probably the Linux distribution which is most famous because maybe it has most of the advertisement on the internet, I don't know. Simply for newbie, you know, you will just install it and it looks some quite working. So if you are happy with Ubuntu, use it. If you need performance, then CentOS 8 or CentOS Stream or Clear Linux, which is the clear winner of all. Again, Dune Pro case. Mr. Richard Mustafa asked that already for 10 times. Clement Belio, does the newest AMD CPUs finally support Thunderbolt 3? If not, why is that? You know, I think Intel finally, and it's not so long, put the Thunderbolt 3 to the AMD developers. So I think ASRock already have now the first officially supported first motherboard with official support of Thunderbolt 3. What are you drinking? Beer, darling. What do you think about open core? Quite very often question. You know, Clever Bootloader was here quite long. Prior to it, there were some chameleons and, you know, super crazy stuff. When Clever Bootloader came to the ground, it was amazing because now it started working. You know, it was so much easier than anything else prior to it. By the way, I'm doing Hackintoshes since 10.4 system, so I have no idea if it's 12 or 15 years old. Simply count it yourself. When was 10.4 system released? So when Clever Bootloader appeared on the scene, that was really, you know, storm. That was amazing. Now people try to think about OpenCore as something again super amazing. You know, I don't have the need switch all my builds now to OpenCore because why? You know, don't fix what's working. Don't fix what ain't broken. So if all my builds are working perfectly on Clever Bootloader, I have no need to switch to OpenCore. If you are the first time Hackintosh builder, you know, if you will have luck with the OpenCore on the first run, then you will be probably happy. Sorry, for next few years. Maxis Music Studio. Is the Vega 64 good for an Hackintosh? I don't have enough money for the Vega Frontier Edition. Maxis Music Studios. Vega 64 and Vega Frontier Edition are in fact quite the same cards. The only big difference which you can see is the Vega Frontier Edition has 16 gigs of VRAM. So it depends for what use case you want to use. You know, even GTX or RTX 2080 Ti have no chance to have 16 gigs of VRAM. So for, I was using Vega Frontier Edition really for a long time for my video production. But in fact, Vega 64 sometimes have slightly better performance in the raw power when you don't need the 16 gigs frame buffer. So Vega 64, amazing card for Hackintosh. Still, by the way, as to the previous comments about the 5500 XT and 5700 XT, that's why I don't recommend it, because they need the Catalina to run. But Vega 64, Vega Frontier Edition Radeon 7, amazing to run with Mojave. Stone Temple Pilots Legacy. You know, I like the band, but it does not look like they are asking me now about some Hackintosh questions. Please, I make some questions, but not answer at this time. Darling, I am running from top to the bottom. Sorry, maybe I haven't seen that, because it's so tiny on my screen. Chris Bamford, I connect my MacBook Pro 16 to a Dell U3219Q. I have to leave it open or the Dell goes black. What's the best thing I can use to make the screen active while I'm working with the MacBook Pro lid closed? You know, I'm not using any setup like you, but, you know, did you try the application called Caffeine, which will simply disable the power saving features, and that computer will simply never go to sleep. So maybe you can change settings in your system preferences when you close the lid. I have to leave it open or the Dell goes black. You know, maybe it goes directly to sleep, so try to disable sleep, try to run the caffeine application. It's a little widget in your top bar. And that let me know in comments if that helped or not. Again, Dune Pro case. Ben Fitzpatrick, good morning. Good evening. Lucas Rivest, I do visual graphics using hardware heavy graphics. Is a Hackintosh laptop possible? Yeah, again, so I think I answered that already. You know, why? Why Hackintosh laptop? I understand that somebody simply wants something portable. But, you know, I'm using 2011 MacBook Pro and I'm happy with it. You know, I would never buy anything newer with exception of the 2019, the 16-inch, which is amazing. You know, even if you say you are using hardware-heavy graphics, you know, can you imagine any notebook with heavy graphics? I can't. You would probably need some eGPU, and problem of all eGPUs is that it, then it's running at maximum at Thunderbolt 3 speed. That means theoretical limit 40 gigabits per second. But it's better to understand it's running on only PCI Express by 4. Would you connect to your desktop computer super heavy graphics, as you say, by PCI Express by 4? I don't think so. So, laptop, but not for heavy graphics. Facio, I don't know. Hi from USA. Have you added another graphic card to your new Mac Pro? Yes, I've tested a lot of GPU setup. I announced that on my second YouTube channel, which is dedicated to everything else, but not to Hackintosh. And, you know, I've done so many tests and it took me really insane amount of time. Then became new version of macOS, which little bit changed the whole situation. Came new version of Geekbench 5, which also changed the situation. And finally now there are again new drivers in the latest macOS Catalina. So I need to, you know, I'm slowly redoing everything and see where's the difference. And another information which changed the results, which I measured on so many GPU combinations, was that somebody noticed, I have no idea who was that, that when you use GPUs in headless mode, so with no display connected, it have completely different and much lower performance than if we would use some, for example, HDMI dongle, something like this. I'm not sure if you can see it. Wait a second, can you see it? Yeah. So you will just put this into your, like in my case, into the Radeon 7 and the second Radeon 7, and it should have much better performance. But no, it's not true. You know, I think who was that? Max Yuriev or his brother made some tests about this. But, you know, when I run Geekbench, I was able to get, I think, from my... I'm not sure if I will have it somewhere here. Yeah. I was able to achieve Metal Score on my Radeon 7, 69,751. But it's a Geekbench. It's a benchmark. When that was with the HDMI dummy plug connected to the Radeon 7. Without the HDMI dummy plug, my score was not 69,700, but 63. But did it really change my performance in raw power video editing? No. So if you are obsessed by benchmark numbers and you would like to be on top of some chart or I don't know, okay, use this as a trick and, you know, you will be the big boss. But I haven't seen any performance difference if the GPU is used in headless mode or with some display connected. Again, what's the best laptop today to convert? No, sorry, don't ask me on Hackintosh laptops. John Florek, could you recommend a guide for building a good USB map? Guide, sorry, I I don't visit any forums, so I have no idea if there are some good guides or not. You know, I think you can use the I have no idea who is doing that, the USB map script. I never used that, so I don't have experience with that if it's good or not, but I saw a lot of people is using it. Or even you can use the hacking tool, which is quite nice option or alternative, which you can use to do your own custom USB port mappings. Rishad Mustafa, I will not talk about the Dune Pro case. I talked about it and I told you I don't like Steelers. So I will not support anytime Dune Pro case, even they would pay me $1 million just to make single Hackintosh of it. No. Oh, it's running too fast. I lost. Yeah. Franz Pleurman RX 57 versus Vega 56. What would be better suited in terms of support for video encoding, decoding? You know, again, as I said already, if you need H.264, H.265 exports, then the Navy-based GPUs should be better. But needs the Catalina to run. That's the problem. You know, I work completely in ProRes workflow. I would not benefit from it. The 5700 card would be now slowed down for me. James, have you tried building a fanless Hackintosh? If so, what case did you use? No, I never tried to build a fanless Hackintosh. I'm very obsessed with quietness. I hope I say that correct. So when I build computers, they must be silent. Silence, please. So, if you think about Mac Pro now running, here is running my 14-core iMac Pro Killer, and behind me, under the table here on the corner, there is running my recording 14-core iMac Pro Killer. Can you hear now any noise? But it's not fanless, but still super silent. Alex Rudy, is the problem with Adobe fixed in Ryzen? I don't know. First, I don't use Ryzen, only as my virtualization platform. And second, I don't use Adobe. You know, maybe you saw this. So I don't use Adobe. That was my last attempt. No, I'm kidding. You know, I was starting with desktop publishing on Quark Express, and it's really more than 20, 25 years ago. When Adobe came on the market with their first, I think, CS1, I bought the CS1, CS2, skipped CS3, bought CS4, bought CS6. And when they came with the creative collection, how does it call, design collection, I don't know. Simply, I was all the time Adobe user. You know, Photoshop was the echelon of everything. But, you know, I hate what Adobe is doing now with their customers. You know, there was the big situation. I think it was in Mexico or Chile, somewhere down in the America. They simply cut them off. You know, you cannot run any version you like. You cannot run any CS1. Simply, you need the latest subscription. So, why, you know, let's give me a few questions. Why should I want to run Adobe when I can run something else which has much better performance? Why should I pay to Adobe so much money monthly or yearly when I can pay just $50 and have that application with all future updates forever? Can you see the difference? One is short, one is longer. So, no, I don't have idea how is Adobe running, because I don't care. You know, I'm using the best tools anytime. If there will be something better than the application I'm using Affinity. Affinity Series, Affinity Photo, Affinity, it's a Photoshop-like. Affinity Designer, I think it's like an InDesign, and Affinity, I don't know, I don't have it in my doc. Simply also the Illustrator part of it. So it has much better performance than any Adobe application. So if you want to save a lot of money and support a great company, do it. Affinity. But, you know, forget about Adobe. By the way, Affinity is working perfectly on Hackintosh. Chronotech. Congrats, Teresa. Nice work. Excellent guides. You are the explanation goodness. I don't think I'm goodness, and especially not of explanation. I am simply trying to help to everybody. And I was teaching on a university, and as we all know, I didn't say as we all know. I said as we all know. Not all people are smart. So I had to develop some kind of feature in myself, how to talk also to those not so smart people, so everybody can understand me, what I want to say. Ali Zaki, my suggestion for you to make a Hackintosh at laptop. So, oh God. No, I don't want to do it. You know, why, again, explained in my previous part of this video. But also, what I didn't told you, that MacBooks, PC laptops are using super proprietary hardware. If I will tell you now that super compatible motherboard for desktop computer is the Z390 Designare motherboard, then you can bet that if you will buy it, then it's gonna work perfectly fine. But the problem is that on PC laptop motherboards, there is no component quite the same as in any Mac. The goal of Perfect Hackintosh is to get as close with the hardware selection as possible to some real Mac, to some real iMac 2017, I don't know. And that's quite impossible with the laptops. Yes, I saw a lot of people has amazing success with some laptops, but you know, if you will try to buy it now, most probably that person was posted that 2 years ago, so you have no chance to buy the same model. You know, don't do it. Message retracted. Again, I have no idea what does that mean. David Verdugo, what is the best monitor you recommend for Hackintosh? That's like the question like you would asking what's the best car which will drive you home. You know, for anybody else, the answer would be different. For example, I am using 10-bit grading panel, which was crazy expensive. Would that be the best monitor you recommend for Hackintosh? Most probably not, because you don't need that 10-bit option. You don't need super color accuracy. If yes, then okay. But if not, you know, you can use any display. And I mean really any. Simply, absolutely any display. So if you will next time give me more information for what exact use case you want me to recommend some display, then it would be a different story. Norbert Dupsi. Which file system are you using for Catalina install under Proxmox? APFS or HFS Plus? Of course, APFS. Cliff Changur, what's the best laptop today? Oh God, you know, forget about laptops. Or at least on my channel. Hansi Fai, the best screen is with the DDCI control brightness, in my opinion. Sorry, I have no idea what you are talking about. A2000, you skipped some questions. Yes, darling, probably yes. I told you several times. Then my window, which is super long on my 32-inch display, scrolled a few times, and I have problem to find the spot where I left before the scrolling. So I so much apologize. Probably I skipped your exact question. Makis Papadimitriou. Trio. Hi there, I had fully functional Ryzen Tosh Ryzen 5 3600 RX 480 and Gigabyte Aorus Gaming. I was running Mojave and tried to update to Catalina, but now I cannot boot. Okay, you know, I don't know how many times I should say that. Forget about Catalina. As I said in my video about the 5700 XT, if you want to experiment, then go for it. But if you want stable and reliable system, go for Mojave. You know, maybe one day you will say thanks to me. Stefano Ricci. Hi, I have Ryzen 3900, blah, 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 with Aorus, Sapphire, Nitro, using OpenCore, bootloader running 10.15.4 beta. Everything works apart from the wake. Would you know the fix? you know, first be happy everything works, as you say, because maybe in next version it will not work for you. And apart from wake, you know, darling, this new 2019 Mac Pro cannot sleep. So if you have problem only with waking up, then be happy. By the way, I also cannot sleep and I also cannot wake up. Sorry. I hope you are not super disappointed from my answer. Ali Zaki, my suggestions for you to make a Hackintosh at laptop. Oh God, how many times? Mm-hmm. Alien, hi Teresa, if I buy 144Hz monitor, will it work and 144Hz on Hackintosh? Thanks. You know, honestly, I have no idea. I never saw 144Hz monitor. But, you know, I see no reason why it should not work. You know, if the GPU supports it, if the display supports it, if the cable supports it, I think there should be no problem. Lucas Rives, different question. How you can answer my first, but hope you can answer my first. No, because I have no idea where was your first question. Do you think an old Gigabyte X58 AUD7 V2 still perform well, or should I rebuild? You know, if you have to ask if you should rebuild, then you don't need to. Because if you would now have exact idea that you need, I don't know, X299, that then you would probably would or should rebuild. But you know, X59 is amazing. You know, I'm using a lot of server stuff, 10 years old, which I think is little bit similar to X58 maybe, or X79. I don't know. You know, that's amazing stuff. You know, if it still works, then it will probably never die. So be happy. Silvio Scardino. Hi, Teresa. Another quest. The best graphic card for Final Cut Pro. The best graphic card for some poor man or for some super rich person? You know, best GPU for which codec? What's your source media? What's your delivery codec? You know, this everything plays the role. And I told, so I was talking about it already during this live stream. Oh God, we are streaming 1 hour? Oh God, you know, it's too long. Who should watch that? You know, I hate long streams. When I see some live stream, you know, when YouTube will offer me some video which is live stream, I first look how long it was. You know, 1 hour 45. Oh, sorry, I will not watch it. We need to quit, darling. Where was it? So you know, if you really need, you know, the 16-inch MacBook Pro will kick of even the Mac Pro in some specific workloads, and especially in the H.264 and 5 field. So if you need to work with these types of codecs, then go for Navy GPUs. If you need, you know, super raw power, go for Vega or Radeon 7. So Heil, hey, sorry Teresa, it's my mistake, I called you, no, it's okay. You can call me even old pumpkin, I would be completely fine. Okay, so C+E2, okay, so what would you use for virtualization software? In your video, I didn't see you mention the name, is it ESXi? You know, darling, that's the same like with those GPUs. GPU for specific task, I would recommend this one. For another task, I would recommend this one. So I don't use single virtualization software. I use several packages, and based on client's needs, I will simply choose the best one. But what I can say for sure, it is not ESXi. I was working on ESXi, I don't know, I don't count it, simply let's say 10 years, and I am happy I abandoned that completely, because now I am much more free person. You know, some messages are here held for a review, so maybe some haters. Sorry, as you can see, I'm talking to you. I'm not hiding any messages. So, as I said, we are streaming 1 hour and 5-6 minutes. Let's do this last question, which I can see. Karma Film DK. Hi, do you think the 28-core 3175X is compatible with the Mac Pro? I recently bought one and I am now waiting eagerly for my base model Mac Pro that I intend to upgrade for myself. From what, you know, I think Linus Tech Tips, they put it 3175. But I'm not sure if they forgot to mention the X at the end or not. So watch their video. Maybe you will see the specification on some detail close up. But what I know, 3175X does not support 3300 megahertz memory. You would simply need to use the slower frequency, which is the same limitation of the only 8-core model. So I have the 16-core, which is running really on the 293300 megahertz. So, you know, if you have the Mac Pro or waiting for the Mac Pro, you know, I cannot say because I will not touch my for some while, I hope. But, you know, if you don't care about the lower speed, I'm not even sure if it supports the whole six channel controller. You know, try it and let me know, please, under any of my videos or on my Facebook or Reddit. I would like to know that too. I don't plan to upgrade, but this information may help to people on my second YouTube channel. So, you know, I have no idea how many questions I covered. I never done live stream. This is really my first experience. So if you can, you know, if you didn't get the answer to your particular question, because I still can see the, yeah, and I forgot even to show you, oh God, where is it? The chat on the screen. So at least at the end, sorry. If you still have some questions and you want to answer them, feel free to comment under this video and I will read those comments and I will include some of those questions to my next live stream. Will there be any next live stream? You know, honestly, on the beginning of this live stream, I thought this is going to be my first and also the last live stream I've done on this YouTube channel. But I haven't seen a lot of comments, so, you know, I simply thought I will take it as a social experiment, because a lot of people knew I'm getting quite a lot super angry, idiotic, stupid comments for some, you know, super angry people. I have no idea why when all I do is just to help to people. So I was expecting, you know, that the whole chat now is going to be full of those, you know, angry, egoistic, machoid, testosterone people. And it looks my predictions was not like that. So I'm very happy. There was a lot of people who really wanted to get some questions answered. So as I said, right under this video, when it's going to be, you know, saved on the YouTube, I don't know how it's going to now work, write me questions for the next live video stream and I will try to explain to answer to you as much as I can and as much of those comments as I can. So thank you for watching and see you next time, my Hackintosh friends. Is that how I end all my videos? So how should I end this live stream? Again, you know, of course, thanks to all my supporters. There is not much of them, but those who stay for some while really helps me and helps also to you. Because without those supporters, I would not be continue with this what I do. I would not be doing my personal individual support, which you can find now here on my website. Where is the logo here? It's not a logo. So big thanks goes to all my supporters. Much bigger thanks. Not much bigger. That sounds bad. The same big thanks goes to my clients, which are not stupid. They are really smart. And I love to talk to smart people. And I'm always happy when I will see on the other side of the Skype some really nice and kind people. That makes my day better. But what makes me really happy is when at the end of the remote session, those people are happy. And you will see those amazing smiling faces. So thanks to all those people, I can still continue to provide you my support, create my videos, so it can help to even more people and to you. So thank you that you are here for 1 hour and 11 minutes. And let's enjoy it also next time. Okay? Bye-bye.